4 Ezra, or 2nd Ezra, chapter 13. And it came to pass after 7 days, I dreamed a dream by night. And lo, there arose a wind from the sea, that it moved all the waves thereof. And I beheld, and lo, Yahushai, that man waxed strong with the thousands of heaven. And when he turned his countenance to look, all the things trembled that were seen under him. And whensoever the voice went out of his mouth, all they burned that heard his voice, like as the earth faileth when it feeleth the fire. Verse 5. And after this I beheld, and lo, there was gathered together the multitude of men out of number. This is verse 5. From the four winds of the heaven, to subdue the man that came out of the sea. We're speaking about celestial waters here. Peep the numerology. Mayor. But I beheld, and lo, he had graved himself a great mountain and flew upon it. But I would have seen the region or place whereout the hill was graven, and I could not. And after this I beheld, and lo, all they which were gathered together to subdue him were so afraid, yet durst fight. And look at the geometry of the number 8, you know. It's like this has happened before, and it shall happen again. 9, and lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, he neither lifted up his hand, nor held sword, nor any instrument of war. That's verse 9. Now 10, which is 9:01. But only I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it had been a blast of fire, and out of his lips a flaming breath, and out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempests. And they were all mixed together, the blast of fire, the flaming breath, the great tempest, and flew, Salakia, and fell with violence upon the multitude which was prepared to fight, and burned them up every one, so that upon a sudden of an innumerable multitude, nothing was to be perceived, but only dust and the smell of smoke, Salakia, Salak, and smell of smoke, pardon, Salak means pardon. Salak means pardon, right? When I saw this, I was afraid. Verse 12. Afterwards, I saw the same man come down from the mountain and call unto him another peaceable multitude. And look at the multitude here in the 1611 KJV in capital letter, which means that it was likely replaced by something more specific. 13 or 4, and there came much people unto him, Yesharal Shalom, or Jerusalem, whereof some were glad, some were sorry, some of them were bound, and others some brought of them that were offered, and others some brought of them that were offered. Then I was sick through great fear, and I awakened and said, Thou hast shewed thy servant these wonders from the beginning, and hast counted me worthy that thou shouldest receive my prayer. 15 or 6 says, Mayo, shew me now yet the interpretation of this dream. And you hear how Esdras had to fast for a week even to be that spiritual. 7 or 16. For as I conceive in mine understanding, woe unto them, woe means destruction, woe unto them that shall be left in those days, and much more woe unto them that are not left behind. For they that were not left behind were in heaviness. That's 17 or 1 plus 7 or the perpetual geometry of the number 8. For they that were not left were in heaviness. Now understand, I the things that are laid up in the latter days, which shall happen unto them and to those that are left behind. Therefore are they come into great perils and many necessities, like as these dreams declare. And the ebb and flow of the numerology from 9 to 1, 18, was now understand the things that are laid up in the latter days, which shall happen unto them and to those that are left behind. 19, which is 1, therefore they come into great perils and many necessities, like as these dreams declare. 20, or the number 2. Yet it is easier for him that is in danger to come into these things than to pass away as a cloud out of the world. And the Most High allows these current days terminologies like the cloud because of these very scriptures, and not to see the things that happen in the last days. And he answered unto me and said, Yahweh shall speak in Ezra, the interpretation of the vision shall I shew thee, and I will open unto thee the thing that thou hast required. Whereas thou hast spoken of them that are left behind, this is the interpretation. 23 or 5. He that shall endure the peril in that time hath kept himself. They that be fallen into danger are such as have works and faith towards the Almighty. Know this therefore, that they which be left behind are more blessed than they that be dead. And that's 24:6. You know, it's half a dozen is like preparation. Know therefore that they which be left behind are more blessed than they that be dead. This is the meaning of the vision. Whereas thou sawest a man coming up from the midst of the sea, the same is he whom God the Highest hath kept a great season, meaning much time. And I misspoke, Salaki. I'm not 100% if the angel who was given Ezra his vision was in fact the Yahushua, but right now we're speaking about our Redeemer, Salvador, HaMashiach Yahushua. The same is he whom the Highest had kept a great season, which by his own self shall deliver his creature, and he shall order them that are left behind. 27 or 9. Whereas thou sawest that out of his mouth there came as a blast of wind and fire and storm. 28 or 1. Or 7, and that he held neither sword nor any instrument of war, but that the rushing in of him destroyed the whole multitude that came to subdue him. This is the interpretation, and this is there is no original story in Hollywood. All these superhero stories, it's literally that. Yahushua just shows up without holding an instrument of war and makes everybody look goddamn ridiculous, like that MTV show. Behold, these days come when the Most High shall, it's a lot, the Most High, will begin to deliver them that are upon the earth, and he shall come to the astonishment of them that dwell on the earth, and one shall undertake to fight against another, which we're already beginning to see in right now in the beginning of 2024, end of 2023. And he shall come to the astonishment of them that dwell on the earth, and one shall undertake to fight against another, one city against another, one place against another, one people against another, and one realm against another. All right, I'm making the reference to the story behind Mortal Kombat, even. And one realm against another, 32 or 5. Or 6 if you multiply the numerology. So here it is for 5 and 6. And one shall undertake to fight against another, one city against another, one place against another, one people against another, one realm against another. And the time shall be when these things shall come to pass. The signs shall happen which I shew thee before. And then shall my son be declared, whom thou sowest as a man ascending. Right? Speaking of the recent Hollywood release, Aquaman, there isn't a single original Hollywood release. It's all from the scriptures. And it's no coincidence why the very beginning of Hollywood, it was mostly just flat out scriptural remakes. But yeah, this is pursuant to Aquaman, right? And dodge the hijack, dodge the historical hijack. 33 or 6 or 9. And when all the people hear his voice, every man shall in their own land leave the battle they have won against another. This is the Most High. This is how the Most High sets people up in their personal lives. This is how the Most High sets up the whole world and nations one against another. Because listen. And when all the people heard HaMashiach Yahushua's voice, every man shall in their own land leave the battle they have against each other, one another. 34 or 7 or 12. Which is one. And then a numerable multitude shall be gathered together as thou sowest them, willing to come and to overcome him by fighting. But he shall stand upon the top of Mount Zion. And Zion shall come. You know, like the canonized 66 depict, like that movie Nope, like scrolls rolling out the heavens, and shall be shewed to all men, being prepared and builded, like as thou sowest the hill graven without hands. That's 36. And this, my son, HaMashiach Yahusha, shall rebuke the wicked in vengeance of those nations which for their wicked life are fallen into the tempest, and shall lay before them their evil thoughts and torments wherewith they shall begin to be tormented, which are like unto a flame, and he shall destroy them without labor by the law, which is like unto me. And whereas thou sowest that he gathered together, I mean, this is just beyond heavy right here, man. Ugh. And whereas thou sowest that he gathered together another peaceable multitude unto him, those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Salamancer the king of Assyria led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, and so came they into another land. And it's interesting that I was thinking about the Indian epics, which literally, to this day, if you open up the Indian epics, those were some of the best kept historical works of technology beyond what we have nowadays. Warfare, aerial warfare, laser warfare, high level technological warfare. And this is what the Most High is describing here, you know? When they heard HaMashiach Yahusha, every man shall in their own land leave the battle they have against one another. So all these people that are going to come against my Redeemer and Savior, El Salvador HaMashiach Yahusha, were already fighting against each other, like those Indian epics depict. But what's interesting is that although they kept the historical detail of those wars, it all begun here in ancient Israel, ancient America, ancient indigenous Israelite America. Amarukans, that's the hijack. And an innumerable multitude shall be gathered together as thou sowest them, willing to come and to overcome HaMashiach Yahusha by fighting. But he shall stand upon the top of Mount Zion, and Zion shall come, and shall be shewed to all men, being prepared and builded. Sion, you know, like P-S-Y on, you know, Sion, see. Sion. That's why the heavens are veils. That's why evil is nothing but a veil. It's an e-veil. They're veils, so you ultimately don't see.